Welcome to Heritage Wine and Liquor, heritagewineandliquor.com. I am Keith, this is...
I'm Justin. I'm the guy.
He's the guy! And it's Justin's Picks, and Heritage Wine and Liquor is located at...
Right on the corner of Arapaho Road in Quebec, just right next to the Safeway, right there in the same shopping center, right here in Centennial.
Big yellow letters on the front.
Yeah, just says Heritage Liquors, come by and check us out. We got a wonderful selection of wine, wonderful selection of beer, spirits, pretty much anything and everything you'd ever want.
The phone number?
Phone number is 303-770-8212.
Fantastic. And
it is heritagewineandliquor.com. Go to the website, check it out. We have our weekly email specials, the Davey deals that are always out there. Always some really great deals going on. Some things that we just kind of find discounted pricing on from our distributors, and then kind of just pass the savings along to the consumer.
Right.
There.
And sometimes they find things like this bottle. And yeah. Justin found this, and
this is pretty unique, actually.
This is new to me too.
This is an Oregon wine. You'll notice it's labeled as a Baco Noir, which yes, that is a grape varietal, and it has no relation to Pinot Noir whatsoever. It's actually a hybrid grape of a French grape called Folie Blanche and just some unknown Vitis vinifera. So no one really knows what the other grape is. Actually, it used to be really widely planted throughout France up until 1951, where the French government actually decided that no hybrid grapes could be used in winemaking, period.
Okay.
So it's made here in the U.S. a little bit. You see it up in Oregon. You do see it in Michigan, New York, some of those other older wine-growing areas here, or the lesser-known wine-growing areas, actually,
in
the U.S.
Right.
But it's a very unique wine, actually. I went into it not really knowing what to think, actually, because I've never had a Baco Noir before.
Baco Noir.
But it's more medium-bodied. It actually drank a lot like a Syrah, is really kind of what I thought. A lot of those blueberry, blackberry, more dark berry flavors, kind of leathery.
Okay.
Oh. Get a little bit of spice to it.
Some meat to it.
Yeah, definitely. Would be great for some charred meat, I think.
Really?
Nice steak, maybe even something a little bit lighter, some lamb, pork tenderloin, something like that, but definitely something with a little char on it, I would say.
So if I like Spanish wine?
Actually, you probably would like this, although it's not quite as bold and extracted as a lot of the, like a
Tempranillo
or Tempranillo or Monastrell or anything.
Not as much fruit.
Exactly, and the tannins are actually much more soft.
Okay.
It's even a little bit more velvety than the Merlot tannins, typically.
Very good.
So just very easy drinking. Like I said, fruity, complex, but at the same time, it has some nice elegance and some nice complexity to it.
Right,
That anybody really, all along the wine spectrum, whether you're just a beginner or somebody like you or I, who are kind of a little geeky about this stuff.
Right.
So, it's something that a lot of people will definitely enjoy.
I think Justin, too, is saying also it's not flabby.
Yes. Yeah, it's not flimsy at all. It definitely holds up to really anything. It holds up on its own, but yet it really complements food really well at the same time.
So you're saying charred meat?
Charred meat. I'm thinking, some grilled meats on this one.
Okay.
I wouldn't do anything as light as poultry. I think that might be a little too light for this wine.
Sure. Okay.
But definitely something a little
burgers?
Bit heavier. Burgers would actually do really well.
Okay.
Yeah. Any kind of beef, bison, pork, lamb, those sort of things would definitely complement.
And
this
it is summertime,
well.
So maybe chill it down a little bit. Make
just
sure
a little bit. Maybe about 50, 55 degrees is all.
Okay.
So just with a slight chill on it. And actually, the last time I had it, it had that slight chill on it. And it really helps bring out the earthy notes on it. You really get that leather. The fruit is much more subdued, and you're picking up all these other things.
The dirt.
So, the dirt, exactly.
Wine, sounds kind of weird, guys like dirt.
I know. It's strange.
Whatever reason.
But yeah, you use leather as an adjective to describe a wine. People are like, what in the world?
And a lot of wines have that. You just have to, as we say, it's you just have to pay attention to what's in your mouth.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
Yeah. So grilled meats, Baco Noir.
Baco Noir.
Price is?
$21.99.
Okay.
Every day. And actually, I just got this in, put it on my shelf this morning.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just got this in the store, put it on the shelf this morning.
Okay.
I had a bottle of it a couple nights ago that the rep left with me, and... absolutely wonderful.
And something like this will be around the store for how long?
It should be pretty readily available, actually.
Okay.
I'm hoping that it's not going to be limited or going to go by the wayside anytime soon. So.
Now, where is it in the store?
It's actually in my Oregon section, just sitting right on the top shelf, along with all those other great Pinot Noirs that you find from Oregon.
And pretty soon, there's going to be, right down the aisle here, there's going to be a Justin's Picks display.
Yeah, exactly. We're going to put a nice little rack up there so we can feature these items that you see on these YouTube videos, and that way you don't have to go hunting all over the store for them.
Exactly.
And hopefully we'll be able to work out some kind of deal where we'll be able to put these wines on in-store specials or some some kind of deal for the consumer also.
And so in about a week, and then one more thing that I was made aware of today from Andrea is that about a week from now, we've got the big sale going on.
Yes, we have our big quarterly wine sales going on. We have over 1,500 different wines on sale during this.
It's a
great time to come in and stock up on your favorites.
Right.
Pick out something that you've just been eyeballing forever, but you never really pulled the trigger, but hey, now it's on sale, why not?
Exactly.
So it's really great. We have a ton of wine guys around here, so you can come in, ask any of us for suggestions, if you just need cases grabbed, whatever, and we'll make sure that everybody gets taken care of.
And that'll be sent on email, newspaper, anything you guys really push it out.
It goes out everything. It does start on July 20th, and we'll go through July 26th.
Okay.
So and wonderful week.
And there's something on the registers that people
Yeah, exactly. Once you come in, if you want, we do have a big flyer that has every wine listed by category.
Okay.
And it's about 8 or 9 pages long, but you definitely go through there. I have a lot of people who actually just come in and hand me this, and they say, I'll be back in 2 hours, make sure this is full.
So, nice.
We can definitely
do that.
And
you say yes, sir, yes.
Absolutely.
So there's a lot of information in the show, so thanks for hanging in there today. It's Baco Noir.
Baco Noir from Girardet.
Okay.
Which is actually in the Umpqua Valley, which is another area that you don't hear a whole lot about in Oregon. It's pretty much Willamette. That's it.
Google it.
Yeah, exactly.
You'll find out more about it.
Pretty
cool
stuff.
In here and ask the staff, and they'll tell you more about it also.
Absolutely.
And it's Heritage Wine and Liquor, heritagewineandliquor.com. Phone number again is
303-770-8212.
So come in the store, see Justin, see the staff, and you'll be happy, and we'll be happy to see you. And we will see you next time on Justin's Picks.
Absolutely. Cheers.
Cheers.